Good morning to all of you. Yesterday, the Delhi High Court two judges bench, Honorable Justice Vipin Singhvi and Jasmeet Singh, both of them literally wrapped up the drugs controller, stating that the court cannot be taken as a gullible or naive public. Don't think that whatever you give in the affidavit, it will be believed by the court. That means don't try to cheat the courts. You are literally cheating the court. These are the words used by the Honorable High Court to a drug controller. Why this thing happened and what is the background also, we have to come to know. Right, on May 26th, actually that came up for hearing, maybe a few days before itself, one person by name Deepak Singh, he filed a public interest litigation against the politicians like Gautam Gambhir, who was a famous Indian cricket player and presently MP, BJP in Delhi. And Srinivas NSM is a youth Congress leader and some OP members also. Some OP member was also there. So the allegation second OP is Dilip Pandey, right? So the allegations in the public interest litigation is that the politicians, they are hoarding the medicines and they are able to get bulk quantity as and when they like, and the ordinary people are suffering a lot to procure the medicine in the open market and the many other medical shops. This is the allegation. That means the public interest association requests the Honorable Court to give a writ of mandamus to the drug controller to see that the medicine is equally and rationally proportionately distributed to the medicines so as to be available to be distributed to the general public whoever in need of it. That's it. But the problem is the politicians, they are able to get it in bulk quantity. This is the measure. How they are able to get it in the bulk quantity? So you might have seen the case of our Anandaya. So many politicians, of course it is allegation, whether it is true or not, I do not know. But it is learned that so many politicians, they are filling their buckets with the so-called Ayurveda medicine of Anandaya and taking them to their respective districts. Luckily, the Honorable High Court and also the government of Andhra Pradesh was pleased to give permission to him to distribute the medicine. Otherwise, this would have been hoarded or block marketed. Right? So, in this connection, when the matter came up for hearing on May 26th, the Honorable High Court of Delhi, it has ordered the drugs controller to launch a probe into the matter as to how so much of medicine has bulk quantity has come into the position of Mr. Gautam Gambhir. So what happened is the MP Gautam Gambhir, he has almost distributed 4,000 packets of Favi-Flu, F-A-B-I, Favi-Flu, which is a COVID-19 drug. Still 285 strips are remaining. That means he has distributed to almost 3,700 or so. When there is a shortage in the local market, how he is able to get the medicine like that? That is the question put by the Honorable High Court. For this, so the reply, the status report filed by the drugs controller yesterday, that is on Monday, that is on 31st May, is that according to rule number 5 of Schedule K of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, so a doctor is empowered, since it is a foundation, so when it is given free of cost, they are exempted from the so-called Drugs and Cosmetics Act. So this is what drugs controller, he wanted to say. So the DC told the distribution, that means the director, drugs control, so drugs control general, he told the distribution appears to be covered by an exception in Drugs and Cosmetics Act as per exemption rule number 5 of the schedule. So what for this exam, the court has gone through the exemption. The exemption says that a medical practitioner gives such medicines in bulk to his own patients, but 4,000 is an alarming number. The court immediately asked, suppose how the distributor has given to this man, even though drugs controller stated that the Gautam Gambhir's foundation under the supervision of a doctor from Garg hospital, they have distributed the medicine. So The court asked, suppose if a medical officer goes to the so-called distributor and asks for 4,000 strips, will he give? No, normally he is not expected to give, because the medicines, they are expected to be under the control of the Drugs Control of India, and they have to be distributed equally, not to these people. So how can such heavy load be given to a foundation which is not a doctor, right, like that? So anyway, the standing counsel on behalf of the drug controller, Mrs. Nandita Rao, she was also held up. Whether she has gone through the report or simply she forwarded it to the court as a status report, right? So this is the problem. Now here another problem has come up. Mr. Gautam Gambhir, he stated that he will go to jail. Whatever some people may file public interest litigation, because he came into the politics to serve the people, he will be serving the people. Or even though the court jails him, he is ready to serve the people. That means he is ready to supply so much of medicines. Then the court took exception for the statement. So they know, the court says, we know how to deal with the issue and we'll do so. So politicians, they appear that they are the saviors of the public, whereas they are actually creating the problem, because they are taking the medicines in bulk quantity, so that the ordinary person cannot get the same. How a donor can send it to a foundation? It was done, so it should not be done, right? Lastly, the High Court has come down heavily on the Drugs Controller, stating that you want us to shut our eyes, so you think that you will get away with the false statement? Don't we know that ground reality? You mean to say that you can get away with whatever you write, and the court will turn a blind eye to your statement? You cannot take us for a ride. If you think that we are gullible, we are so naive, we are not. We will give you back what you definitely very hard, will give you back very hard. That means we'll transfer you some. If you are not interested, you say, we'll give it to some other person. Like that, they have come very hardly on this drugs control. So please remember, so whether you are an officer, whether you are a legal officer, whatever it is, you have to follow the rule of law. You have to follow the procedure. But don't be guided away. Don't try to support the politicians. You will be held responsible. Definitely, the court will not take it as anyway. The court once again asked the status report on Thursday. Let us see what will happen. Thank you very much.